we are back with the bombshell allegation that the lawyer for Stormy Daniels is calling fact. The adult film star was apparently threatened with physical harm unless she stayed quiet about her alleged affair with Donald Trump.
I'm stating a fact, and the fact is that my client was physically threatened to stay silent about what she knew about Donald Trump. We have been approached by six separate women who claim to have similar stories to those or to that of my client. Two of those women, at least two, have NDAs. We are in the very early stages of vetting those stories. I want to preach caution and restraint. We are not vouching for these stories. We are investigating them.
With me now, Rick Wilson, Republican strategist and Paris Denard, CNN political commentator and member of the Trump Advisory Board. Gentlemen, let's get to it, starting with all things Stormy. Rick, you tweeted that Trump is worried about this whole Stormy scandal because of financial reasons and not political. Why?
I think he feels like his political base is secure. They've told us over and over they will tolerate any amorality, any scuzzy behavior. I mean, he could be hitting it with her on the White House lawn and they'd be like, yay, go MAGA. But I do think he is worried now that as the NDAs start to look a little more brittle and as Stormy Daniels and other folks look at angles by which they could litigate on this, I think he knows it's going to cost him legally, it's going to cost him financially, it's going to start eating up his bandwidth. He's going to have to actually pay lawyers. They're not all going to take out a home equity loan to cover up his dalliances with porn stars. So he's going to end up with a lot of costs. And I think also, you know, we got to also think about Melania's prenup with him. So there may be a money equation there as well that he puts him at some risk.
Why, if the president, I mean, obviously he is involved, two Trump attorneys connected to keeping Stormy quiet here. If the president is innocent, why not say so publicly?
Well, I don't think that the president wants to dignify this story, be it true or false, because it's something that is personal and has nothing to do with him as the president of the United States of America. It didn't happen, if the allegations are true, while he was a candidate for president. It didn't happen while he was sitting in the Oval Office. This is something that is just terribly embarrassing for the First Lady. That's what I think about every time I hear these stories. I'm sure
but
that...
But it happened, Paris. Let me just jump in, because mm-hmm. It happened days before the election, and the president on his Twitter feed does seem to weigh in on everything else.
Sure. I think the payment from Michael Cohen from his personal account, from a line of credit, whatever, from his home to Stormy Daniels did happen before the election. But the alleged affair.
You don't think that's a big deal, the timing?
OK, I feel you struggling here. Let me help you out here.
No, I can't.
Donald
I'm not
Trump
struggling.
Has a long,
pattern
pattern of engagement with a variety of women to whom he is not married. Michael Cohen has long been out there doing these NDAs for these various women that Trump was involved with sexually and in other capacities. This is something that is a long pattern of behavior. Now, are you telling me that Republicans have never once brought up the fact that Bill Clinton screwed his way through Arkansas? No. They did it all the time. It wasn't because it was before he was president that makes a difference. It's that he did it at all. And the fact that Donald Trump
has
an attorney.
No, you interrupt me. Let me interrupt you. No, it's different because at the time, Bill Clinton was the attorney general and he was a sitting governor of Arkansas. And the claims came by someone who was a sitting elected official. Donald Trump, these allegations took place before.
Hang on, let Paris finish.
These allegations took place before he was president and before he was a candidate. He was not a public official, and there's a different standard. It's totally different. So you're comparing apples and oranges. If, however, something happened to President Trump while he was in the Oval Office, then that would be something different. But that's not what happened like what happened with President Clinton.
If your standard is that low and you're okay with him screwing porn stars, if you're okay with him screwing porn stars, just say the words. I am okay with Donald Trump screwing porn stars. Can you say that for me, Paris?
Because you know what I will say is that you have no respect for Mrs. Trump. You have no respect for his children. You have no respect for his family.
I'm sorry.
Because this has nothing to do with him as a candidate, and it has nothing to do with him as the sitting president of the United States. You can dig up dirty laundry, and I pray to God nobody goes back in your past and picks up something that has nothing to do with your present time as sitting here on this commentator. But it's rude and it's offensive. It has nothing to do with him as a president. Criticize the president for his policy. Criticize the president for his tactics. But don't go back and criticize him for something that's nothing to do with the presidency.
For folks across this country because of his behavior towards people. Don't you dare talk about respect when he insulted the family of Humayun Khan. Don't you dare talk about respect when Donald Trump insulted John McCain's war service. That is a man who has no respect for anyone on this earth. And the fact that you're defending him on that speaks much more about your character and low standards
you have. Rick, I don't know you. Rick, I don't know you, but I would advise you to not question my character because you don't know me. But if you like to talk to me about my character and what I believe, I can have that conversation separately. But what I will say is if you're going to impugn the integrity of the president, do so on things that are relevant to him as a candidate and as the president, not things that have nothing to do with his presidency. That's all I'm saying. Continue to rabble.
You can just say it.
Guys, no personal insults. No personal insults, please. And let me jump in because, Paris, here's a question for you. As we are talking about the payment coming out just days before the presidential election, let me flip it around. If this was Hillary Clinton, what would happen if Hillary Clinton's lawyer paid off an accuser days before the election? How do you think Trump would react? Fair question.
I think on the issue of a payment by the lawyer, I think he would have a reaction. Absolutely.
And what kind of reaction do you think that would be?
It would be negative. I'm certain it would be negative. But I'm also saying that is a separate issue from if she did something while she was a candidate or if she did something while she was the sitting Secretary of State. That is what I'm saying is let's separate apples from oranges. If we're going to talk about the payment and the timing of that, that's fair. But to bring up this the allegation that happened long before he was a candidate or president, I think
connected.
It's irrelevant. And
listen,
I think that's
I
why
hear
he's
you
not
loud
commenting
clear, because this happened. It happened years and years ago. And I think you're absolutely right in pointing out he was private citizen Donald Trump at the time. But it is entirely germane because we're talking about the payment and the hush, this hush money days before everyone went to the polls to elect him as president of the United States. That is, you are allowed to connect the two there.
You're allowed to raise the question as to why Michael Cohen did that in his personal capacity as his lawyer. But at the end of the day, there's attorney-client privilege, and that's not going to come out. And I think all of this extra comment about what Stormy has to say or what she doesn't have to say is just to embarrass the First Lady, because her commentary has nothing to do with the presidency. Let's have a conversation and let the lawyers figure out if there is something untoward about the payment. Did it come from the Trump Organization? Did it come from President Trump? Michael Cohen says it didn't. Michael Cohen said he took it out of his own line of credit from his mortgage to pay for it because he is someone who supports the president and didn't want this getting out. That's on Michael Cohen, not on the president.
Go ahead, Rick. I know you want to jump in. Go ahead.
You know, the argument that Donald Trump's lifelong pattern of infidelity, adultery, shattering every vow of every one of his marriages by his own admission, and the fact that Donald Trump screwed a porn star. Now, I don't think Melania Trump's going to be more embarrassed by what Michael Cohen or Stormy Daniels has to say than by the fact that a few months after she had a kid, her husband was screwing a porn star. And that's what you're saying is okay. I get it. You accept that. That's part of your moral framework. That's part of your moral landscape. Good for
Rick,
you.
You know
go
what?
Do.
Bro, I'm not going to tolerate that.
Paris,
you don't know my moral framework.
You don't tell me what you're going to tolerate.
I am going to tell you what you're not going to do. When it comes to me, it's okay for Donald Trump to screw a porn star.
It's okay for Donald Trump to screw a porn star if he's just not the president.
Keep saying it more and more. Keep saying it more and more. Get it out. Get it out of your system. We all know that's what you want to say. But at the end of the day, he's still the president, and you should have a little bit more respect for Mrs. Trump than to continue to talk about this. Have a decent conversation about the payment and Michael Cohen. Go ahead and do that. This has nothing to do with his candidacy. It has nothing to do with the presidency or his policies. Let's have a conversation on policy.
Her husband shouldn't have screwed a porn star.
Okay. Paris and Rick. Wow. Thank you both for that conversation.